Good evening, everyone. I'm really honored and humbled to be here this evening. I'd like to thank Towson for allowing me to share a little bit of my story with all of you this evening. Hopefully it'll be a bit of an encouragement to those in the room as well. I thought I was going to be the interactive portion of the program tonight, but we've already done a lot of standing and sitting, so maybe I'll just ask for some hand raises to start. If you are a first-generation college student or graduate, can you please raise your hand? It's a lot of people. If at least one of your parents or grandparents didn't graduate from high school, please raise your hand. Also a lot of people. We share this, obviously, and it's an important element of who I am and my journey and my story as well. And I'll share a little bit more about that as I go through tonight. I'm lucky I had two incredible parents who loved me dearly and were always there for me. Unfortunately, I lost my mother 18 years ago to a heart attack at the young age of 55. She saw way more potential in me than I ever saw in myself. I'm very thankful for the encouragements that she gave me from a very young age. My father did not graduate from high school. He had an undiagnosed hearing disability that made it extremely difficult for him to be able to learn while he was growing up. He was also an immigrant, so he moved to the States with two parents who did not speak any English, who demanded that they assimilate. And that was a little bit of a challenge for someone who couldn't hear. And so school was extremely hard for him. And so when he got into high school, he decided that that was not the path for him, and he dropped out and started working. And he's by far the... hardest working person I've ever met. When I was growing up, he had at least two jobs most of my life. In some cases, he had three. But never sacrificed being there for everything I did. And he worked that hard all those years to earn this honest day's living, to be able to clothe me, put shelter and food on the table, and be proud of the life he was delivering to his wife, my mother, and myself. For some of you, Towson might not have been your first choice. It was not mine. Towson chose me through a scholarship that enabled me to come here and learn and grow as an individual. And based on the conversations that I've had tonight with some of the folks at the table with me, I can see how much you're growing. And I expect you will all have great careers and lives ahead of you as well. When I was at Towson, there were so many things I didn't understand. I didn't have parents that could help me navigate college. Were not able to help prepare me for the corporate world, which was not even the world that I expected to go into. When I came to Towson and entered in the accounting program, I actually planned to get into law enforcement. I wanted to join the FBI, and life corrected my direction, redirected me towards corporate America, primarily as a result of my high school girlfriend, who became my fiance, and now my wife for the last 21 years, almost 22. I can even remember how unprepared I was, and actually being here tonight at this dinner reminded me of my very first fancy meal that I had to go out to. I'm not sure if this still happens this way, but accounting firms would pick you up in limos to try to recruit you. And so I was picked up, taken to a fancy restaurant, sat down in front of all these forks, knives, spoons, cups, plates. I had no idea what the hell I was supposed to do. And so the life that I've fallen into, the success that I've been able to garner, was not meant for me, but I'm incredibly thankful for the opportunities that have been provided to me. When my father retired a couple of years ago, after working for 57 years, I wanted to honor his tremendous amount of hard work and effort and love that he bestowed upon me and that my mother bestowed upon me. And I decided that the way to do that was to give back and to establish this scholarship. So now I'm going to switch directions on everyone a little bit. And I'm going to ask you a question, another question. How many people, if I asked you to quit everything you were doing, follow me to try to solve world hunger? Raise your hand if you're willing to follow me trying to solve world hunger. Be honest, don't lie. There's a few hands that went up. Okay. So every now and then I like to walk around different communities and just talk to people. And I recently ran into a gentleman named Sam in our community here. And Sam's homeless, and Sam is hungry. And so I'm going to ask you another question. How many of you are willing tonight to walk with me to meet Sam and help meet his need and feed him this evening? Raise your hand if you're willing to help me on that one. A lot more hands have gone up for that one. Why is that? Well, it's probably because the concept of trying to solve world hunger is an immeasurable task, very difficult to see how you would go about doing that. It's probably hard to get around that, wrap your mind around that. But when I introduce an individual, someone you know you can help, a lot more people are going to say, let's go do that. Let's make that happen. And so for me, establishing this scholarship fundamentally is tied to that. I truly believe if you can help one person in the hopes that that one person will help somebody else, we can help many people by just helping that one person. So I ask everybody in this room, regardless of age, status, what you have in front of you, to not run away from the big problems we face as a society, as a country, as a global community, because they do seem impossible to fix. But I ask you to look for that opportunity to help one person and know that if you're successful, you will end up helping many. Thank you all again for allowing me to be here tonight. If there's anything I can do to help anybody in this room, please don't hesitate to connect with me. I would love to be able to do so if there's something I can do. Thank you. Enjoy your evening.